हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू द लेक्चर सीरीज ऑफ माइक्रोवेव एंड रडार। टुडे वी विल सी माइक्रोवेव डिश एंटीना, दैट इज द लास्ट पार्ट ऑफ आवर थर्ड यूनिट, दैट इज माइक्रोवेव पैसिव कंपोनेंट्स। सो इन माइक्रोवेव डिश एंटीना वी विल सी what is the dish antenna. So the microwave dish antenna is also known as a satellite dish antenna, which is a dish shape and which has a paraboloid. So this type of shape is there. So this is a माइक्रो डिश एंटीना विच इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड एज अ सैटेलाइट एंटीना। सो इन दिस टाइप ऑफ एंटीना इट इज डिश शेप टाइप ऑफ पैराबोलाइड एंटीना। दिस इज अ पैराबोलाइड एंड डिजाइन टू रिसीव और ट्रांसमिट इंफॉर्मेशन बाय रेडियो वेव्स टू और फ्रॉम अ सैटेलाइट कम्युनिकेशन। इट इज बेसिकली यूज इन it will be also work as a dish antenna or a satellite communication antenna is there, where we have the paraboloid and this type of feeder line is there, or we will also call this one as a transponder for simultaneous transmission and reception. The term mostly common means a dish used by consumer to receive direct and broadcast satellite television from a direct broadcast satellite in geostationary orbits. Construction: the micro dish antenna uses a parabolic reflector, a curved surface with cross-sectional shape of parabola to direct the radio waves, so it is called parabolic antenna. The shape of this microwave antenna is in the form of dish. Therefore, it is popularly known as a dish antenna or parabolic antenna. High directivity is the main advantage of dish antenna. Then we'll go for principle of operation. The paraboloid shifts or the dish is there that will reflect the signal to dish of focal point. This is a focal point. So assume this is a particular paraboloid or dish shape is there. So some sort of signal will come like this one, and that will be reflected back to this transporter there, and this transporter is there that will be accept the energy signals. Okay, so this feed horn is especially in front end of the waveguide that gathers the signal at or near the focal point and conduct them to a low noise black down converter, that is a LNB. This is a LNB, low noise black down converter is there, where the all signal will be come, that LNB signal will convert. This LNB is there, this will convert the electrical signal to the radio signal to electrical signals and shift the signal from downlink C band or K band to L band range. Then the direct broadcast satellite dishes use LNBF, that is a low noise band filters, which integrates the feed horn with the LNB, a new form of omnidirectional satellite antenna which is not used as a directed paraboloid dish and can be used on the mobile platform. Same is used for the transmission and reception of mobile signal at the mobile tower. Modern dishes intended for home television use are generally 43 cm to 80 cm in diameter and fixed at one position. So this will be also work as a dish antenna for TV transmission, which has a length is of 43 cm to 80 cm in diameter and which will be fixed at one position. for the K-band reception from one orbit position overlay small dishes still cause problem. However, including rain fade and interface from the adjacent satellite. So what will be the application of this microwave antenna? Basically used for point to point radio telescope, radar antenna, home television, satellite. So point to point radio telescope, radar antenna, home television and satellite television, we have to use this type of antenna, microwave dish antenna, we have to use it. Okay, so in this lecture we will see what is a microwave dish antenna, use of microwave dish antenna, function of microwave dish antenna. So in unit number 3 we have studied the microwave components. In that one, multiple junctions we will study E-plane junction, H-plane junction, its definition, construction and property. Then combination of E-plane junction and H-plane junction, that is hybrid junctions. Then here we will go the review of third unit, hybrid junction. Then we will go for magic T, definition, construction, working principle, rat ring junctions. Then we will see ferrite components. In ferrite components we will study Faraday's rotating principle. This is important, Faraday's rotation principle. And on this one we have studied the working of isolator and circulator. Then four port circulator, gyrator is there. We will also study the gyrator, use of gyrators, how many ports are there for gyrator. Then we will go for waveguide accessories, what is use of waveguide accessories. So in waveguide accessories we will study, first one is flanges, then corners, bends, tapers, then twist and couplers. In couplers we have studied directional coupler. Then two antenna we have to use it. First one is horn antenna and another is microwave dish antenna. Okay, so this is a total part of unit number 3. Okay, thank you and happy learning.